Hello students, this is the second part of report writing. In the last part we have learned about the newspaper report. Now in this part we are going to learn about the official report. So students, how can we write an official report that we are going to learn here? So open your books, page number 173. On this page number, the point is official report. Now listen carefully what is the information is given there. Official or business technical report are formal report written in response to instruction received from someone in authority. So some kind of any person who is in authority, that person is giving some kind of instruction. So according to that instruction, the report is made for any office, for any business, for any technical issue, that is called official report. They are also referred as the survey report. So these official reports are also called as survey report because they are investigating in nature and are written after studying or surveying, for example, a subject area, a situation or the working of an industry. So these reports are made by the investigation after studying and surveying of that subject, that area, that situation or that industry. This report are made, therefore this report are called survey report or official report. It is essential, it means important, for these reports to present facts clearly and concisely. It means
briefly
or shortly, because they will be used to take decisions. So these reports need to be used with the fact and with clear facts and very briefly, shortly. You can follow the guideline below to write official report. So there are given few guidelines for you to write any official letter. The first one, the first step in writing an official report involves the collection of data through investigation, inquiry, meeting, survey and etc. So first step is to write an official report, we need to collect data through our investigation, inquiry, meeting, survey etc. etc. Second point. The second step is to arrange the information in the following format, which is commonly used for the purpose. So after that, we have to collect the information in a particular format. And there is given the format of that report. First, from name and designation of the person writing the report. So suppose you are writing a report to an office. So first of all, you have to write from here and name of that person, designation of that person, we have to write here. For example, Deepak Jain. His designation is district education inspector Nagpur. After that, we have to write date there after leaving one line. So for example is 15 May 2020. whom we are writing our letter, we have to write to, after leaving one line, write your to, give comma, and write the name, designation of the person to whom the report is sent. For example, Dr. Shashi Prakash Chief Education Officer District Center Department of Education Nagpur. After that, we have to write title of the report. For title, it means subject, but we have to write in this official letter, instead of subject, we have to write title. So for example, here is the title is Primary Education Program. After that, next point is terms of reference. Terms of reference, in it we have to write who authorized the report, why it is being made, what the report has been asked to survey, etc. Leave one single line and after that write terms of reference. So here we can write after terms on terms of reference and instruct as instructed by the Minister of State of for Education, a survey was conducted to assess the implementation of the government's 2018 to 2020 primary education program in 4 villages in the district. After that, abstract or summary. It means in it include when the report is very long so that busy senior colleagues may get the essence of the report quickly without having to get through the main body of the letter. So after this, we have to write the main body of the letter in short as a summary. After that, body of the report, continuing the finding of the investigation. After that, conclusion. In conclusion, we have to write containing the report, interpreting of the facts and his her comment, and finally signature of the person. So after terms and references, terms of references, there is given a point in here, findings. It means how the report is, how the survey was done, what kind of information given from which point. So there is given the writer visited the 4 villages of Aknur, Sherli, Shampar and Venkatpur to observe and assess the program. The findings of the study are as following. According to records, number 1, according to the records maintained in the local panchayat offices, the number of students who enrolled in 2018-2020 increased from 23 to 50 in Aknur, 14 to 47 in Cheril, and 20 to 70 in Shampar, and 30 to 95 in Venkatpur. B point. While a dropout of 7% was reported in Cherley, the other villages were able to maintain retain their initial strength for the entire course of the academic session. C point, it is confirmed that the midday meal scheme was being satisfactorily implemented in all the four villages. D point, except for three cases in Aknur, primary school in the village had all the students vaccinated for typhoid and cholera. Last and E point, it was verified that free distribution of books and stationery was done in all four villages as per the record. So this is the finding, how the report was made and what is the summary of that report is given here. After that, next point is conclusion or recommendation. It means the authority is giving some kind of recommendation, some kind of suggestions. Now here are given suggestions. The government program for improving primary education in the state seem to have succeeded in Nagpur district. It is recommended that permission be granted for the requirement of more trained teacher and for the section of funds for the renovation of schools building in the villages where this study was conducted. And after this conclusion or recommendation, we have to write the signature of that person here. After completing findings, we have taken the A, B, C, D, E, this kind of point. After that, there is given conclusion or recommendation. And after that, last, right here, signature of that person. Who is the person setting this letter? Deepak Jain. So write D, Jain in this way. And after that, that person's name, for example, Deepak Jain. In this way, we can write any official report. First, from name of the person who is writing this letter or this report, his designation, name of the place, date, after that to whom this is sending, that person's name, his designation, place, title, category, subject, terms of reference, what is the reference used, findings, how the information was collected, that we have to write here, conclusion of that person, and finally the sign of that person. So students, in this way, this part ends here. We are going to stop here. Have a good day to all of you. Thank